My name is Dr. Solomon Sosemski, and I've been a cardiologist at Sherman Hospital for approximately 29 years now. And now that we're moving to the new institution, a couple of the memories that I have of situations here at the older Sherman Hospital come to mind. They're very era specific. I've had the pleasure of working with a lot of other wonderfully eccentric cardiologists, one being my senior partner who is now retired, Dr. Irwin Robin. And in days gone by, smoking was still allowed, and smoking was allowed in the hospital as well. Dr. Robin was an avid pipe smoker, and one of the things that would always be happening would be he was relatively absent-minded, and he would be talking to someone, smoking his pipe, and then turn around and empty the pipe right into the trash bowl, not looking to see whether there was anything in it. And it became so frequent that the fire alarms would go off that we always knew where Dr. Robin was, because the code reds would tell us exactly where Dr. Robin was. If there was a code red on 3 North, we knew Dr. Robin was on 3 North because he was the one setting off all the fire alarms. Of course, smoking has been banned and that doesn't happen anymore, but that was a very common occurrence at that time. Another event that comes to mind was during one of our quarterly staff meetings. Approximately 20 years or more ago, we had a show called Shermalot at Sherman Hospital, which was a show put on by the entire staff, not just medical staff, but nursing staff and ancillary staff, anybody who had any ability to sing, dance, or even just wanted to participate was in that show. Dr. Richard Powers, a surgeon at the time, put this whole idea together, and he was a very charismatic and unusual character. Well, little known, unbeknownst to any of us, we had our normal quarterly staff meeting, which was a sleepy affair. You know, you eat too much and you're just kind of half paying attention. When all of a sudden the back doors of the hospital, or rather of the assembly hall, burst open, and in runs Dr. Powers, dressed in full cowboy regalia, with 2 6-pump guns, shooting. Nobody had any idea what was going on. It was his way of advertising Shermalot, but I think if he had done that today, he would have been shot dead by security immediately with 2-gun shooting. So that was one of the other eccentric stories. Lastly, I don't know if anybody recalls, but we had one private home. I don't know if you guys, somebody else will tell the story. One private home left in the parking lot, or our current parking lot, in the current Sherman campus. And this home was occupied by an elderly lady who did not want to sell. And that was the last home that remained on the campus itself. And we couldn't build or expand our parking lot or do anything because of that home staying there. At the time, the hospital was able to secure a purchase agreement, but it was contingent upon the death of that lady. And she lived and she lived and she lived until she died of a ripe old age, well into her 90s, and allowed us to finally build in that area. But I was always thinking, if she had a medical emergency, would she come to Sherman Hospital? I don't know the answer to that. Those are my stories.
Hello, my name is Marlene Kelly, and I was hired as a registered nurse in 1972, so I've now completed my 35th year with Sherman Hospital. My favorite story is one that concerns why we lock the linen chutes. Because back in the, probably late 70s, early 80s, we had a group of rather mischievous nurses' aides, as they were called at the time, and they convinced one of the orderlies that going down the linen chute was like a very fun ride at the amusement park. So this innocent young kid jumped in the linen chute and proceeded to fall several floors down, and all you could hear as he was going down was the thump, thump, thump of his head hitting the wall. And when he landed in the soiled linen in the basement, they all stuck their head in there and said, "Are you okay?" About 30 seconds later, they hear, "Yeah." Well, it couldn't have hurt him too badly, because that young man grew up to be one of our neurosurgeons. And this is the true story of Dr. Young Chung. So if anybody ever asks you why do they lock the linen chute doors, I always tell them it's to keep the medical staff out.
Hi, my name is Rick Jekyll, and it's my privilege to serve as the chairman of the board of Sherman Health Systems. I've been involved with the hospital on the board for 32 years now, and thinking back over those 32 years and all of the, as we get ready to move over to our beautiful new facility, of all of the things that have happened here, fond memories include our children being born here, not so fond, but part of life, my mother dying here, all of the new things that happened here, the cardiology program, the first of its kind for a community hospital. I remember when we did that, when Dr. Hassan Casey started that program, and then all of the additions to the original structure here at 934 Center as it just grew like Topsy over the years. The Graham Pavilion, the beautiful new med-surg wing, and now as we get ready to head west for the new facility, I have to say that my fondest memory of the all of the three decades plus are the people. I was thinking about this just a moment ago, running the tape back through my mind. We have got absolutely wonderful people who work here at Sherman as clinicians, as administration, as caregivers, as volunteers, doctors, the whole spectrum. And I think the very best part of all is that we're picking up our entire cadre of people and moving them off to the new hospital. So the best part, well, it's the people, and the people are still going to be with us at the new Sherman.